Hi, all of us want to support exclusive breastfeeding. One of the challenges we have is the initiation of lactation or lactogenesis stage 2, which may take a couple of days in most of the mothers. There are a certain group of babies where extra support is needed during this period because they are at higher risk of their blood sugar dropping, and the initial 2 days of a low milk output is not as tolerated in these groups. One of the recent concepts that has come up to help us tide over this problem is antenatal expressing. So antenatal expressing is nothing but expressing the milk from 36 weeks onwards. You can target the high-risk groups, so the women who have diabetes in the pregnancy, the women where the fetus has been shown to be growth-restricted, multiple pregnancies where you are more likely to deliver the baby a bit premature, and any other risk factors like medications in the mother that may affect breastfeeding or the blood sugar in the baby, like beta blockers. So if you fulfill any of these criteria, your obstetrician can advise you to start antenatal expressing. We usually consider starting it at 36 weeks of gestation because there is a small risk of stimulating the release of oxytocin, which is also a uterine contracting agent. And so there is a small risk of premature labor. There are studies which have been done in Australia, and a large study has also shown no real risk of premature delivery and no increased risk of admission to the NICU, which is again indirectly no additional risk of prematurity. So that is the reason we start with 36 weeks, because 36 weeks onwards is not too far from full term, even if there is a problem with premature delivery. The colostrum that the mother expresses, she can express 5 minutes, 2 to 3 times a day. Hand expressing is better because the milk output is not high and you may traumatize the breast if you use a pump. So teach the mother how to hand express. The colostrum starts coming in drops and you can start storing it. This is called colostrum harvesting. You write the date and time and store this, and this can be used after the birth of the baby. The advantage of this is twofold. One is that we have some mother's milk already in store, and the second point is that it shortens the duration taken to attain the lactogenesis 2, that is for the mother to start producing enough milk. So the chances of a baby needing supplement with formula in the first day or two is very limited. Of course, this doesn't cover the group of premature babies, for example, who are admitted to the NICU after birth, because we don't suggest antenatal expressing before 36 weeks. But once you realize you're likely to deliver early, you can consider expressing. And within the first hour of birth, if you start expressing, it's a big help as well. So antenatal expressing is not as widely known, so this information needs to be shared. And if you know anyone who has diabetes or who has a growth-restricted fetus, recommend them to start antenatal expressing. They can discuss with their obstetrician as well and disseminate this information as possible. I hope this information is useful, and there is no real side effect that has been shown, and benefits. It sensitizes the mother to breastfeeding, it sensitizes to antenatal milk expressing, and this skill will support breastfeeding even later on. The main advantage is that the milk letdown starts early, and so your need for supplementary formula is much reduced, and chances of exclusive breastfeeding is very successful in these cases. Thank you.